Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, friends. Ira Epstein with your weekend edition of this metals market update. And I'm putting it out early. It's 1:40 p.m. Central Daylight Time. I'm watching paint on walls dry. So I know that not much is going to go on. The G7 meeting is taking place. You've got the Korean situation on the 12th. You got the FOMC right in front of us next week. There's a whole slew of information, and the markets have come grinding to a halt. It's really that simple. If we look on a daily basis, gold and silver slightly lower, the copper another gain for the day. The loss that you saw in platinum yesterday, palladium rather, and platinum, came back today, and don't know why, but the market came back up, sitting here around the 906 level. Bitcoin down a little bit, not doing much. Dollar index slightly higher at the expense of a number of foreign currencies. But it's G7, what comes out of it, that'll rein the market on the early talk on Sunday night and Monday. I look for the president to absolutely give no quarter to anybody. If he's going to listen, it's because they're going to come at him and offer him something, not because they say they're entitled to this, because they've always had it. We'll see where that plays out and how it goes. Then June 15th, is what bluff poker game is this? Because the U.S. is supposed to slap China with another $50 billion in tariffs. We did allow their company, ZTE Corporation, to go back into business. That's a big deal, but maybe that's a big deal in payment for getting this Korean sit down to take place. We don't know what's behind the scenes, but we'll find out. When I look at the gold chart, the one thing I can tell you, from this move, this big sideways move, looks like a cigar or something on the street, eventually we get a breakout of prices. That price will end up with prices either going up like that, or they're going to end up with them coming down, but it's going to give us one of the two. The longer it goes sideways, the bigger the ultimate move. Some people even will, right here, buy a call, buy a put, and they'll sit and wait. There's nothing wrong with that. You go further out, you're buying time when you do that, but that's what a lot of these people do. And if they buy that time, sometimes they ride further out of the money against it so that they collect something on their premium. Right now, when I look at it, I have a higher high and I have a lower low. The market did run up to the green line, which is the 100-week average, the Bollinger top, and it failed again, making a move back towards the 18-week moving average. You got 1888.90, that number's 1883.80. So you're very close. In terms of momentum, it's pointing down. To get bearish, you've got to close under that 1283.80 level. When we go to an area chart of closes only, you've gone from a high, recent high of 1253.20 to 1291.30. You're about $6 over that, but certainly not over that 18-week moving average of closes, so we'll still say this market is a down thrust. When you look at the chart here, I think you see it clearer. You can see how the market is working its way down into that. And when you put on the swing lines, you'd have to get over 1306.80 to bust this pattern. So you've got a pattern of lower highs, lower lows, and that is under the 18-day average, which adds bearishness to it, with support maybe at 1276.20, the 100-week average. And if it wanted to completely let go, the 200-week is way down here. I always go to my good friends' Bollinger Bands and see what they're calling for. Bollinger Bands are an algorithm designed to keep the markets trading within them 95% of the time, and they adjust to current price action very quickly. So what this market is doing is they have narrowed them in. The downside objective is 1286.70. The market's hit 1289.90 today. It did hit the downside targets recently. It's kept the swing line with lower highs, lower lows. The market is still over the upper Bollinger Band. Prices, if it want to fall from there, the next supports, the 100-day average, and resistance back at 1321.50. Momentum-wise, still pointing down. So basically, when we look at the chart, not a lot going on. When we go to ETF, is this going to give us a clue? Well, the only clue it's saying is bearish. Lower highs, lower lows. You're riding the lower Bollinger Band. You're under the 18-day average and momentum pointing down. There's nothing bullish on the chart. You got to get rallies to negate the bullishness, I mean the bearishness, but there's nothing bullish. What about the GDX, the miners? Well, a little more ray of hope here, but not much. You still have the pattern of lower highs, lower lows. That's bearish. You're closing over the 18-week moving average, which means that counters the bearishness out of that part with the lower highs, lower lows. And as you can see, momentum, it's as flat as can be. The silver market had a great chance this week for a breakout. It failed again. It's not the first time. It ran up into the upper Bollinger Band on the daily charts into the 200-day moving average, and it gave everything up. Yes, it's up for the week, 30 cents, but it gave up the best part of the week. It got to 1693.50, and it's around 1677. But on the daily chart, well, weekly chart, on the weekly chart, you can say this is an uptrend. Higher lows, higher highs. If you want to pick a market to belong, this is the baby to belong. Copper's not bad either. Take a look at what copper's done. Higher lows, higher highs. Now, we know the reason for copper is the potential strikes in Chile. We know that there's been heavy buying of copper in anticipation of that by China as well. You know, you want to make sure you have your stocks to work with. But you are over the upper Bollinger Band, even with the upside momentum not overbought. It either is a breakout from here, and I mean runs, or it pulls back in very quickly. And yes, if it breaks out from here, it can run like a son of a gun, so we'll see what happens. That's a lot of sideways action. In the platinum market, you're still very much in the bear camp. Lower highs, lower lows, stochastic still down, not up. Market under the 18-day average. You'd have to get back through the 916 level to scare the bears in this market at this point. The palladium market joins the silver and the copper. Higher lows, higher highs. It's making a run for the upper Bollinger Band of 1053. That is another 40 cents away, but it's the only number that makes sense on the chart for it. And in the dollar index, while the dollar index is correcting, it's correcting from a big bull move. It's trying not to stay over the upper Bollinger Band, has not taken out a previous low, and momentum remains to the upside. Dollar really is stalling, but it hasn't changed overall what it's doing. I want to talk to you about a new video I just did. So it's 2 days old. And I'm expanding to include with our pivot points now slow stochastic momentum. Now, what's the importance of this? Well, if you're an in and out trader, you're sometimes looking for spots. Where's the support? Where's the rezone? Pivot points uses the previous day's open, high, low, close. There's a whole way you work with the formula to develop line points, and we teach it to you. They're all done on your chart. I promise you, your charting probably contains it. From there, you're looking at a neutral point, be it the pivot, the white, with sell points and buy points. Now, on their own, they're nice, but I think that you can add to the feature of them by going with momentum. And what I do is I put on slow stochastics on a 15-minute bar chart, and I teach you in this how to work with them. So if you'd like to see what this all is, it's free. You're welcome to try it. All you need to do is go to our website at www.iraepstein.com. You can call my staff. They'll put it right out for you, 1, 2, 3. You can come up here if you're watching me on YouTube. Click on the icon. It'll take you. Or underneath it says, click here for Ira's free information. Go there. It'll take you there as well. Might as well take a look at this. It's something new. I doubt that you've seen it, and I think you can learn from it. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a good day.